Hello all, hello my Tangle buddies and art buddies. Welcome again to my Tangle and Inspire session. And so just before we jump into this today's Tangle, I just want to say a huge thank you to all of you who have been taking my video lessons over here, and have also been posting on Instagram and Facebook and tagging me and showing me your artwork. And a few of you have done so amazing work. I'm so glad and happy that I'm a part of your journey, and that I have something to serve you here. So if you are here for the first time, you have come to this channel, you don't know what is Zentangle art. So I just want to say that Zentangle art is a very abstract, beautiful art. And I am a certified teacher, so you can take a complete course on Zentangle with me. Or you just want to see and enjoy this art, or maybe you want to just grab your pen and paper, follow along the session, so that is also okay. So we are going to work on different Zentangle patterns, and today's Tangle pattern, I want to say that it is beautiful pattern. It is one of my very favorite patterns that I often go back to, and this has been a really long time that I haven't gone back, so this is going to be really fun. So the Tangle pattern name is Flutter Tile. So it's one of my very favorite pattern, and it's very beautiful Tangle by Sandy Steen Bartholomew. And she has this website, beesinthebelfry.blogspot.com. And so this is the little journal, handmade journal I created for the Zentangle India Facebook group. And we have this 1 month long monsoon Zentangle journey, and it is basically only for the Indians over here. So we are going to create 1 month long of tangles, and I thought I don't have a so once I've created this aura, let us go to the tangle. So I'll take my pencil and I'll simply start, creating this border like shape. It's really nice. Just very light handedly, you move your cardstock. Okay. So as I said, it's a grid pattern. So I'm going to create my grids in this round shape itself. It's okay if they are not equidistant. So now what I do is, as shown in the we'll create some grid lines. Okay, so at each box I'm creating a square, 4 grids. Okay, like a plus. So once again over here, again over here. So I'm just connecting the horizontal lines. So now what I do is take any of the 4 grids and start creating petals. Okay, petals mirroring each other, so diagonally mirroring. Once again, okay, so once again I'll create a seed like shape or petals. So let us first finish the inner part. So guys, I didn't realize. One second, I'll just So guys, I didn't realize. I just started shading. So what I did is I finished off. I wanted to keep it a bit black, gray, and white. So I used my jelly roll. This is a bit of very dark toned gray shade. So the black doesn't reflect so well. But whereas the white, you know, supersedes everything. So it's really beautiful to see. I like in person this piece is looking amazingly beautiful. So yeah, in the very good daylight I'll take a picture of this and post it on my Instagram, and you can watch that. You can definitely see that. So I'm going to start shading it. The shading is, I'm going to keep it very simple. I'm just going to shade on the grid lines, just few here and there. I keep my white here. I'm planning to go with, you know, smudge it a bit with my charcoal pencil, so that would look really beautiful. So first let me complete the black one. So right from the edges, I just press down my pencil a bit, bring out that graphite. Again, I do the other side. Always take care that you don't touch your graphite. Oh, as I'm saying, I'm doing it. But yeah, got to take care that we don't touch the graphite. So, okay. Yeah, and I just want to highlight this grid. So I have done it very unevenly, and that's what I love about this pattern and Zentangle. It need not be even. Okay, this kind of asymmetrical is like really beautiful. So once again, I press down my pencil a bit. Really well. Okay, I hold my pencil in such a way that I use the edge of the nibs. That is, I won't use the point, but I use the edge here. So you can also do that. Yeah, are you able to hear that screechy noise? Many don't like it. I like it. Even I like my Tortillon movie. So even that, it's very beautiful. So once again, just on the grids. Okay. one-sided. So I feel I can do some more here. It's not really dark as I wanted. As I said that this paper is quite dark, so we really need that black to stand out. And pressing down the graphite, I think, is the only way. Okay, so now it looks good. Yeah, looks better, I think, over here. So you can do this like several times. As you see, I just keep doing it. I'm a bit of perfection at times. So even though there is an asymmetrical, I am okay. Perfectly being asymmetrical. Oh wow, now it's looking really good. So I have my charcoal pencil. I just want to dab a bit just in the center, just very lightly, gently. Okay, then over the side. Then over here. Okay, then I take my Tortillon. You can see that there is a bit of graphite, but that's okay. I'm just using the sides of it. So the sides of my Tortillon is white. So that's really nice. Okay. Wow. Like really looking so nice, huh? Once again, just a bit touch here and there, not much, just okay. So if you don't have that white, it's okay, because this is my gray paper. I just wanted to have some fun with the dimensions. So I'm putting some more white. Very slightly. Just to keep it a bit even and fun. Wow, it's really nice, so beautiful it is. I've put some jelly rolls over here, and I really love this quote, always believe in the impossible. So thank you so much, guys. Thank you for following me. I'll put my signature now. So guys, thank you so much for joining me today, and see you around on Friday for the next class, and take care, see you, goodbye, have a good day.